Hello, beautiful Taurus. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. Hope everyone's doing well. I want to thank you for stopping by if you're a new visitor. And I want to thank all of my lovely subscribers for all their support. We're looking at, is it a fling or is it the real thing at this point in the relationship? If it's easy to tell that, it'll pop out. If not, it won't show. But we are looking at soulmates for you, Taurus. Soulmate energy. I like it. Look at this. The changes in the wind. Some of you may be having a new relationship coming in. For others of you, you know who this person is, but we're definitely seeing a major change in your relationship coming up. And imagine. So be careful what you think. Your thoughts become things. So I like the energy so far. So what we're going to look at is primarily your person, their thoughts, their feelings, their intentions, and their actions towards you in the near future. So we're going to cut the deck three times. We will also clarify everything. So thoughts. Ooh, they think you're super strong, sexy, lovable, that you're really reliable, that you're there for them. This is the Leo energy. We have the moon card, Pisces energy. Your person doesn't really know if they know you. They feel like there's a lot that goes on behind the scenes. They feel like you're quite the mystery. Pisces energy. This person feels a little bit lost, a little bit fearful in the connection in their heart space. The Justice card is Libra energy. It is all about your person feeling as though you are just, that you are very balanced, that you want to do things the right way, that you have a sense of morals and history. Let's see, in their heart space, beautiful energy, the Queen of Cups, Cancerian energy, that's love. It is a soft, nurturing kind of love that this person has for you. The King of Cups, so now we have the Queen and the King. That Scorpio energy, it really speaks to the fact that this person does not really show you or talk to you so much about loving you, but they show you by being supportive. So if you're a captain of a ship, they're going to support you by helping you navigate. But this person shows their love instead of talks about it. When we have the Tower card, we have someone who feels very destabilized by the love. They feel insecure. They don't know if there's a strong enough foundation. They want to build a strong foundation. It also speaks to the fact that you may have had some sort of disagreement or argument that has really made them sort of feel like they're at risk, that the relationship may not last. So it's a fear card, very much a fear. They're holding on very tightly. So they may feel as though they like you more than you like them, that, you know, there are things that are destabilizing the relationship or are getting in the way of your connection. In terms of their intentions, they intend to use their intuition, Cancerian energy, that is all about sort of just, you know, putting your ear to the ground and trying to listen to see what's going on. So their intention is to try to figure things out without asking you. The Fool card says that they also intend to, you know, take a very positive outlook. Now, this Fool card's a little bit different than others because we see a beautiful flower. So this person wants to smell the roses with you. Their intention is to, you know, sort of just use their intuition and go along with the program. The problem is that there's an alligator holding this flower and they don't see it. They intuitively feel like something is not equal here because we have the Tower, the Moon, and, you know, this person trying to use their intuition. So let's see what we have here for the last intentions card. Ooh, your person really intends to woo you. They want to win you. They want a new beginning with you. This person feels as though you look fantastic. You look good. You smell good. You know, you have money in the bank. You have a beautiful home. This is a person person who really wants you. They want to pursue you. They want to lure you into their lair, so to speak, quite literally. So let's see what their actions are. King of Pentacles, I love it. There you are in the reading, Taurus. Your person understands what you value. This is Taurus energy. Your person wants to meet you. You're two people of the same mind, Aquarius energy. They are going to put you on the pedestal, treat you like a movie star, give you stability, give you comfort, give you support, financial, emotional, and otherwise. The Eight of Pentacles, they are in it to win it. Your person wants to transform their life with this relationship. They very much feel that you're their soulmate. They very much have thought about you. They fantasized about you. But it really speaks very much to this person's love for you and what they hope, and they're not very secure in this connection. So, you know, again, and this can be vice versa, but this is very much focused on them and their energy. So it is a deep dive into their thoughts, feelings, intentions, and actions. Let's see what the clarifiers are. So what is it that we need to clarify about the Strength card? Your person is strong but balanced. Why do we have the Moon card here? Ooh, not, interesting. They're not really quite sure what you're doing, and it is their Sagittarius energy that they're bringing in. Again, balancing, when you look at this energy, trying to balance out whatever their fears are, along with their sense of love for you, wanting to be appropriate, wanting to really meet your expectations and exceed them. The Temperance card can mean getting back together if there's been a breakup, but it also means just being very calm, cool, collected, working things out intellectually, staying very calm. It's a very good card, especially when we have the Moon. So when they don't know something, they really take a step back and they look very carefully at it with the best of intentions. The Justice card, in terms of their thoughts, is that you may leave them. For some of you, you may be in a situation where you might have been in a long-term committed relationship, and your person wants to move away or go somewhere, or they might want to break up, but your person, you know, they think that you want to be fair and balanced, but they also think that you are not completely fulfilled in this relationship. So why is the Queen of Cups here for how they feel? They're very guarded. They're guarding their heart. Your person feels like they're going to have to fight for the relationship. The Knight of Swords tells us that in their heart space, they're very much guarding. You know, it's almost like they don't want to open up and really tell you how they feel right now, because they're not sure about how you feel or if the relationship is stable. You know, they fear that you might just out of the blue walk away or break up with them. For some of you, that may have happened, but your person is certainly hanging in there with a lot of love and affection for you. Why is the Tower card here? The Justice card. Okay. So I see this. There's a scenario here that I see also for some of you. Your person may be afraid that you're going to file for a divorce. The judgment released them. They feel, you know, in their heart space, they feel very, very worried. Again, with the Moon card, with the Eight of Cups, your person feels that you may simply be following the wrong path. They feel as though you might be allured by somebody else who's trying to seduce you or trying to date you or trying to spend time with you. So why is the High Priestess here for their intentions? Five of Cups. They really actually don't have any intention to go anywhere. Your person feels as though, I'm just going to sit here and wait. That's my intention. Why do we have the Fool card here with the Alligator? Why do we have the Fool? The Nine of Cups. Your person wants you to be really happy. They want you to be happy even at their own peril. What we see here is a person who is looking at the flower and taking the leap of faith, not realizing that for many of you, Taurus, this may not really be you know, this may not be what you want, but they want to take the leap of faith. They want to operate in the most innocent way possible. That's their intention. So we have the Eight of Wands. They want to make love all night long. They want to talk. They want to travel with you. They want to communicate with you a great deal. That is their intention. Their outcome, here we have the female King of Pentacles. Very loving, very nurturing. There is the desire to have children. There's a desire to take care of children. If this person already has a child, they want to, you know, introduce that child into the relationship. The Star card, the Lover's card, what we're really seeing is soulmates here. So the actions that they take are going to be everything that they can do to nurture your relationship, to make it exciting, to bring positive changes, to really try to be the best person they can be in the relationship. When we look at the Eight of Pentacles, let's look, we have the Clarifier of the Devil card. So I see someone here who feels as though they have to give more than they have. They feel that, you know, their actions are to show you love, to give you gifts, and to quite literally, even if they have to try to control the situation with you so that you stay with them and, you know, you love them. So your person is very sort of hell-bent on the long-term viability of your relationship. They very much want that. Let's look and see what the deck of Island Time Wellness says. Let's see what Island Time Wellness is advising for you. So let's see for our Taurus friends, Island Time Wellness. Tell us something about this relationship, please. What do we need to know? The Chaser. Chaser in codependent relationship. Fear of abandonment issue. Okay, that's very... Now I really understand that this person has been abandoned before. They have abandonment issues. That's what's throwing them into the toxicity of holding on too tightly to you. So Taurus, I'm getting that, you know, they've been through a divorce, it appears. It appears that they've had other chaos in their life, and it certainly is clouding their thought process with you, you know. But I think it's realistic. Once you've been burned or something, you know, it does leave a wound. So let's see what we have here. The Runner. Okay, the Chaser and the Runner. So it looks like you may have this dynamic in your relationship. This is, you know, listening to the ego. The Runner's listening to the ego. It's a codependent. It's a fear of intimacy. So Runner-Chaser is a dynamic in this relationship, which is disallowing the stability. And they're very much afraid that you're going to walk off and leave them, Taurus. So what else? One more card, please. Twin flames, yin, yang, zen. Balance, duality, coupling, complacency. Being very complimentary of each other, complimenting each other. And that's very, very much Sagittarius energy. So that's what I have for you, Taurus. Thanks for stopping by. Sending you love from Chicago. Send some back. Please let me know in the comments what's going on in your love life. Thank you. Bye-bye.